black mayor has been targeted, is now under criminal investigation because he decided to remove Confederate monuments that he had permission to remove. Let me go to the first video. Here it is.
Yo, it's time for this monument to come down. People voted. I tried with a hammer. That wasn't enough. So now here come the tractors. Drive it down. Yes, sirs. Yes, sirs. Yes, sirs. Death to the Confederacy around here. Push that little one over too, bro. All of it. Not in my town, not on my watch. Not in my town, not on my watch.
Damn, that's what I'm talking about. I got more video, here it is.
Death of the Confederate in this town. We're just tied off right here where I tied that piece at.
Let me give you background to this courageous, progressive black mayor who is now under criminal investigation because he did what he was empowered to do. I'll explain all of this. Put up the picture of Mayor Mondale here. This is Mayor Mondale Robinson. Mondale Robinson is the mayor of Enfield, North Carolina. He is now under state investigation after he tore down a Confederate monument. Now remember, he had permission to do this. I'm going to explain that. The town commissioners voted. They approved removing the monument within its jurisdiction. Mayor Robinson could now face criminal charges for personally seeing to its removal. So let me take you back to August, in early August, okay? Early August, Enfield town commissioners voted 4-1. Count that, 4-1 to do what? To remove the monument. And Mayor Robinson, he was at the meeting. He assured them it would cost nothing to the town. As a matter of fact, he said, it won't cost the town a dime. I got this. It won't cost you a penny. Robinson says he spent a day on August 21st, 2022, trying to tear the monument down and recorded himself doing so on Facebook Live. Of course, why would he not? He has the approval of the city commissioners by way of a vote that is legally binding. There's more. Let's put up the chief of police who's on the left and the Republican or conservative, should I say, DA. Enfield Police Chief James Ayers and Andrew Murray, the conservative DA for North Carolina's 42nd prosecutorial district, requested the state investigate the mayor. Now, I want to remind you, you see the police chief on the left? That police chief works under the mayor and the commission. He decided to team up with the DA and request that the mayor be investigated for getting rid of a racist monument. Mayor Robinson doesn't know why his own town's police chief requested the state to investigate him. Atlanta Black Star received a statement from the North Carolina Bureau of Investigation, which says, on Sunday, August 21st, 2022, the SBI received requests from the Enfield Police Chief and the DA to investigate property damage at the park in Enfield. Now remember, the property is owned by the city, okay? The investigation remains ongoing. Once the investigation is complete, the case will be submitted to the DA for review. The DA will determine whether criminal charges are appropriate, not the SBI. What? We're talking about city property within the city limits. The city voted to remove the damn thing because it's racist and could create rioting, and they did so. And the mayor, he was bold about it. That's what this is about. I want you to understand it. He was in your face with it. He celebrated the toppling of their monument. Now he's under criminal investigation. Since the monument's removal, the loyal white knights, let's put it up, the loyal white knights of the KKK, which is the largest, most active group of the KKK, they have decided to release various flyers. The flyer reads, "White people of Enfield, you have let an N-word tyrant stomp on your white heritage. What will you do? Don't let them get away with anything." Put up the picture of the chief and the DA again. You see, both of you are on the side of the KKK. Please understand where you are right now. Both of you are on the side of the KKK. The Ziploc bag also contains seeds and kernels. Mayor Robinson, who's a progressive, by the way, and founder of the Black Male Voter Project, was elected mayor of Enfield, North Carolina, May 17, 2022. Enfield has about 2,350 residents. 85 to 90% are black. Robinson said he ran for mayor because he wanted to be a voice for black residents who are facing threats from gentrification. Another concern of his is the threat of white nationalists unsettling his majority black town by rallying behind a Confederate monument in a town park. Now, let me give you some background to the law that they're trying to get him hung up on. In 2015, the state of North Carolina passed a law. They passed a law declaring monuments, racist monuments in particular, memorials and works of art owned by the state may not be removed, owned by the state, okay? They cannot be moved, they cannot be relocated, they cannot be altered without approval of the North Carolina Historical Commission. However, there are some exceptions to the rule. Mayor Robinson cites the Confederate monument posed a safety risk, which is a provision in the law, okay? So you can remove them if it provides a safety risk. And the mayor adds that the monument was owned by the city and not by the state. Despite the ongoing investigation, Mayor Robinson stands by his decision to personally remove the Confederate monument and feels he is within the law. He also believes its removal is a good move for the majority black town in which he received 76% of the vote to beat out an incumbent mayor this past spring. But look at that. When you have the narrative, the law, the people, everything on your side, they still find a way through a very, very small loophole to try to put a black leader in his place. Well, it won't work, dear brother, because I'm supporting you. There are many others who are standing with you, standing for you, and advocating for your city to continue to progress without the detriment and the disease of racism overtaking it. Attorney, what are your thoughts here?
Well, I think that this is just antics. The thought is that they need to keep him in his place, to put him in his place. And that's really what is being signaled and said, because if they were all working toward a common goal, which is to the humanity of those people that they're supposed to serve, then there would be no issue about him removing that monument. No, this is the focus here of leadership in this town appears to be a matter of, let me make sure that you stay in your place. And too often do we see this. And, you know, and also seeing members of the KKK leave these flyers. It's just so interesting to me how it says white people, they're attacking your heritage of Confederate monuments. Confederates were losers. So if your heritage is being a loser, to act this way really just signals that this is exactly who you are in terms of having this loser mentality and not wanting any person who is black or in a position of power or authority to actually be able to do their job. No, the main goal here seems to be to put him in his place, and it tells you that the leadership isn't there for the people.
Yeah, and here's the thing, when they say this is white heritage, listen, white people, I need you to reject that. Your heritage, your historical heritage does not have to be connected to white racist people. You can push back on that narrative just as we can, and I encourage you to do so.